Hello, everybody! This is Ultimate Lifeform RB, and welcome back to the new Super Mario Bros. Wii playthrough. In our last episode, we continued World 9 with 9-3 and 9-4, which means we are halfway done with World 9. We've only got 4 levels left to go, and it won't be long before this playthrough is done. However, we still have some tough levels to overcome, and we are starting this episode with 9-5. The interesting thing about 9-5 is, although it's the 5th level of World 9, World 9-5 actually uses the World 3 scenery, so we have a winter stage to deal with. And it's not that bad, save for a couple sections that can be rather annoying to deal with. But really, compared to some of the levels we've already seen in World 9, this one isn't really all that bad. Now, this is a vertical stage, so we're going to be going up for pretty much the entire stage, and it can be roughly divided into 2 sections. The first section, the lower section, which we're going through right now, is what I call the Cooligan section, because of the penguin enemies called Cooligans. These guys are going to keep coming out of the pipes, and they're pretty easy to avoid as long as you're paying attention and you make sure that you're not in their path when they move across the screen. Now we're entering the second section, which I call the Fuzzy section, and arguably the more difficult section because of how annoying some of the platforming can be with these guys. Especially getting that star coin right there. We've already got the first 2 star coins, but to get this last star coin, it's going to take a little bit of work, because what we have to do is, well, first of all, we have to make sure that we don't fall off, but at least we took out that big fuzzy so he won't be an issue. The thing is, you want to land on one of these little blocks, and you want to freeze that fuzzy that's all by himself, and jump up. I was seriously not expecting to be able to pull that off. I actually thought I was going to miss my jump, but I was able to do it, so we're going to potentially leave World 9-5 with all the star coins, which I'm okay with. Alright, all we have to do now is make it to the end. Oh! Don't want to get too hasty here, because I don't want to die right at the goal. That would be absolutely embarrassing. And we make it, folks! That is World 9-5! Made it look easy, but that took some practice. So just like that, we have 3 levels left, folks, and we're going to continue on with World 9-6. Let's not waste any time, let's keep going. World 9-6 utilizes the theme from World 8. So here we have the lava, you know, fire and brimstone, all that crazy stuff. We got lava plumes, or lava geysers, I should say. But really, this level could fit right in with the levels of World 8, because it's a pretty gnarly level, no doubt about it. The thing is that you have all these platforms that are above the lava, and some of them go actually into the lava. So you're going to have to really be on your guard when doing your platforming, because that can almost happen. You can almost die. And the thing about this world, well, I've already talked about this before. You really want to be careful when going through these stages, because World 9 does not contain any checkpoints at all. So you die. Back to the start, and holy crap, how did I not die? I was practically in the lava right there. I'm not gonna complain, obviously, but seriously, I'm kind of shocked that I didn't die right there. Take that, fire chomp. Yeah, those guys are here to complicate things, but really, World 9-6, it's not a hard level if you're patient. It requires patience and being able to, you know, position yourself correctly, and don't be hasty when making your jumps. You have to watch the platforms carefully, the ones that go in and out of the lava, to make sure that you don't meet a fiery fate. Okay, this next star coin can be pretty risky, but I'm gonna go for it. wall slide and wall jump back up, and we're still alive. All right, we are doing quite well. And there's the fire chomp once again. Die. Get out of my sight. I don't want to see you. I don't want to talk to you. You are not my friend. Now. Whoop. You gotta be kind of careful with that jump. And... whoop. All right. And we are on the move. And now we're getting close to the end. This one has the platforms that... I think all the platforms from here on out will dip into the lava. So... be very careful. Let's see. Wait. Jump. Jump. Okay. All right. All right. All right. We're getting somewhere. We're getting somewhere. We're getting somewhere. Wait for that geyser to go down. Oh. Oh my goodness. I was not expecting to get that coin. I seriously thought I had screwed up because I saw the geyser go down. I see the platform and I'm like, oh shoot. But now I gotta find a way back. Whoop! Okay. Okay. Take a moment to breathe. Breathe, Matthew, breathe. Okay, this is a tight situation to be in. Made it! See ya later, Fire Chomp. Oh my god. Okay. Okay, please. Let's make this. Let's make it. Let's make it. Let's make it! Did it! Oh man. That last section, though, I was so nervous because I did not have an easy way to make it back. Whew. Man, that's a rush. Man, these World 9 levels, man, they are something else, no question about it. But ladies and gentlemen, we have come down to two levels. We have World 9-7 and World 9-8. And, well, these are the only two levels that stand between us and completing the game. However, we're going to take a quick trip to this Toad House that we unlocked. And let's see if we can get some power-ups. Now this time, I do not have those patterns in front of me, so I'm gonna have to do this legitimately. Now once again, the only way to access a Toad House in World 9 is to rescue Toad from one of the levels. So, you know, the only way to access this is rescuing Toad. And the same applies to World 8. Okay, Bowser. Hey, we got a mini mushroom, that's better than nothing. And not even half of the board. Wish I had those patterns. Oh well, at least I managed to show that off. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, we've only got two levels left to go in World 9, which basically means, by extension, we've got two levels left to go in the game. So this playthrough will soon be drawing to a close, and if you're wondering why this episode is going to end a little differently compared to most of the previous ones, that's because I did continue recording after doing 9-5 and 9-6. I attempted to do 9-7. Let's just say that didn't go so well, and I ended up stopping. So you'll see 9-7 as well as 9-8 in the next episode. So this episode is going to be cut short a little bit, but all the same, I do want to take this opportunity right now, even though we still have a couple videos left to go before the playthrough is officially done, I would still like to start gathering everybody's opinions on this playthrough as a whole. Since we are getting close to the end, I would like to hear everybody's thoughts, everyone that's followed this playthrough and watched it. I would like to know what you guys have thought about this playthrough, whether you've enjoyed it, whether you haven't enjoyed it, and, you know, just your basic thoughts overall on the playthrough as a whole as we prepare to finish things off really, really soon. So that's a wrap on this episode of the new Super Mario Bros. Wii playthrough. If you folks liked what you saw, be sure to like and leave a comment and tell me what you think. This is Ultimate Lifeform RB signing out for now. I will see all of you in the next episode.